We got a real mystery here. An African-American female, 28 years of age, is going through a mental health episode. Parents call the police. The police come, put her in handcuffs in the back of the police squad car. And all of a sudden, she's being lifted, airlifted to a hospital for a head injury and outside of the police car. And they have no idea why she was in the location she was. Let me bring you to a place called Hancock, Georgia. Let's put up a picture of this family. You see the portrait they are holding? That's the young lady at the center of this saga and mystery. A woman in Hancock County is now in a coma, after the family was told she escaped out of the deputy's cruiser while it was moving. Now, her name is Brianna Grier. Now, come back to me. There's something really ironic about this story already. You see, according to the parents, Brianna was going through a schizophrenic episode. They called the sheriff. The sheriff deputies responded. They put her in handcuffs, put her in a squad car in the back and said, well, they're taking her to the sheriff's office. But why not to the hospital? And if you've ever been in the back of a police car, police cars, they do not open from the inside. Somebody had to let her out. And how did all of this happen with a 28-year-old woman in handcuffs in the back of a squad car? I got questions. And it looks as if the Georgia Bureau of Investigations, well, they got questions too, because they are now looking into this case for possible criminal misconduct. So between Thursday, July 14th and Friday, July 15th, Brianna Grier came home and was having a schizophrenic episode. Her mom, Mary Grier, called the Hancock County Sheriff's Office for help. Two deputies arrived at the home between 12 midnight and 1 a.m. and put the 28-year-old in handcuffs, put her in the back of the deputy's car. She was supposed to be taken to the sheriff's office, but ended up somewhere else. Her father, Marvin Grier, says he just wants to know the truth. The quote says, I would do what any parent would do. And that's what we're trying to do, is find answers. Marvin Grier said, Marvin and Mary Grier were visited by Hancock County Sheriff Terrell Primus. Let's put a picture of the sheriff up. This is the sheriff of Hancock County, all right? That's Sheriff Primus. He's known as Dr. Primus, actually. He told them Brianna was airlifted to Grady Hospital. Now, Hancock, Georgia, or Hancock County is nowhere near Grady Hospital. But Grady Hospital in the state of Georgia is considered to be a leading hospital for head trauma. All right? So they airlifted her to the hospital. They were shocked, obviously, to get this information. They just called the police because there was an emergency and their daughter needed help. If I had known it was going to turn out like this, God knows, I would not have called them to come and get her, said Mary Grier. The Griers were told by the sheriff that Brianna had kicked her way out of the deputy's cruiser. Now, Brianna is in a coma and has two fractures in her skull. Mary Grier could not believe the condition she was in when she saw Brianna in the hospital bed. She said, I just broke down and cried because it's just ridiculous how she laying up there with tubes and pipes everywhere on her for no reason, because it didn't have to be that. It didn't have to be that, Mary Grier said. Brianna has 3-year-old twin girls, Maria and Maria with an H. Marvin Grier told 13 WMAZ that Brianna had dreamed of being a veterinarian. The only answer the family wants to know is what happened to their Brianna. Once again, GBI is looking into this, Georgia Bureau of Investigation. We have no idea if there's video footage, dash cam footage, the officer's footage, maybe footage from a convenience store. or something in the area. None of that has been provided or produced for the family here. Now I have to agree with the family. There's something here that does not quite make sense. But I have to also highlight the protocol. When you call 911 for a medical emergency, which being in the middle of a schizophrenic episode is, that's non-criminal. That's a non-criminal emergency. Why is it that the deputies responded, put her in handcuffs, put her in the back of the squad car and was taken her to jail? You know the sheriff's office is, that's jail. She was going through a mental health crisis. Why are we treating a person who's going through a mental health crisis, but why are we treating them with incarceration? That's a protocol issue. That's a policy dynamic. And I have to say this, and I hate to say it, but it's true. When you call 911 and the police come, that means you're calling a gun to the scene. Now, I'm not sure if they plan to take her to the sheriff's office, do an evaluation, and then to the hospital. But that wouldn't make sense if that was the protocol. Once again, we're back to a policy dynamic. So not only do you have something that went wrong as far as transport is concerned, we also see clearly that a policy dynamic is wrong in Hancock County. There's no way in the hell somebody should have to go in a police car with handcuffs because of a medical mental health emergency. All right, David, what are your thoughts on this case?
I mean, too many Americans think that when police have this logo that says to protect and serve, it means to protect and serve, when in fact police are there to dominate and end a threat. And police are used to dealing with what they conceive to be threats. Somebody with schizophrenia is not a threat, as you pointed out, Dr. Richey. This is somebody who's going through a mental health crisis. You don't lock somebody up that way. You don't put them in handcuffs. You don't agitate them by throwing them in the back of a police cruiser. You have to figure out a way to sort of de-escalate, to soothe, to calm them down, and to try to find the appropriate people who are trained to deal with them. To me, though, this is yet another example. You cannot count on police to be able to do this. They are used to now, and their training is again to put down threats. If you've got somebody who's got emotional problems or schizophrenia, paranoid schizophrenia, I feel like we're all in this situation now where you can't call the police. Call a doctor, call a nurse, call a neighbor, call a psychologist. Don't call the police because you're putting the person's life in danger.
Yeah, and these very good people thought they were doing the absolute right thing by their child. And now their child is up in a hospital bed, not able to respond, in a coma. In a coma. All right, we're gonna stay on top of this story because I think there's a lot more to it.